See right here, if you buy the box set, it looks to be around $199. You can let's see, pan up a little bit. Yeah, $199. So it's $199 for the box set, and that gives you this controller and then the game as well. And then I chose to actually use the serial number to activate it on Steam, so you are able to do that as well, just because Steam keeps upgrading their stuff and whatnot. So I know that the game would be better than the disc version. And also, when I tried to do the disc version, it acted like it had a Trojan and all that crap that it does with the older software. So yeah, I highly recommend this setup if you're getting into RC planes. I mean, this thing's so cool. It's exactly what you need. And then of course the program is right here, Real Flight. And then you can see the setup here that we'll be using. And then this correlates with that controller that you've seen on screen. This is actually the controller. So it's a very cool setup. I highly recommend it if you're trying to get into RC planes, just because it's way cheaper. $199 versus, $379 for one of these planes, and you wreck it the first time you fly it. It'd be way better if you got in the simulator first and kind of flew around. It'd just give you a way better idea of how the controls work on RC planes. So let me go ahead and I'll show you my RC collection too, and then we'll go and actually play the game. And then real quick, I'd also like to show you our RC plane collection. So we actually do in fact have the Thunderbird jet that we're flying. So that's the other nice thing. Like any of these jets that you own, you can check them out before you go out to the field. And we have a number of the other planes too as well. So we have the Twin Otter, and then we have the A-10. We have a couple of the Sport Cubs, and we have the Cessna too. So a pretty good collection of RCs, as you can see. And yeah, we've got the Turbo Timber, and then like I said, we do have the F-16. So yeah, this game works great to coordinate, flying these before you get to the field. So you definitely have to check it out. The link's in the description. And let's go ahead and get into this video, and I will play some of this game with the controller and everything like I showed you. Okay, so the other cool thing about this is that you can use Tracker IR. So for the rest of this video, I'll go ahead and turn on the Tracker IR. I just use the little clip-on thing to the hat, but I actually do have the infrared clip as well. They're wick about the same, so it doesn't matter. And then, of course, the Track IR camera is up there on the top. And then you just go ahead and turn on the software for Track IR. And then put on your hat, like so. Let's see, the camera's lighting up, and then, oh, I think it's because this is open. It gives me problems. You got to turn this on afterwards. Looks like we're good. Okay, there we go. Yeah. Okay, let's try this again. All right. Here we go. Now we can look around. Sweet. And let's go ahead and open up the game again. Put our controller down here. Just waiting for the game to reload. And then you need to go to view head tracking and then turn on Tracker IR. And there you go. And let's go ahead and play some with the Tracker IR on.